GPT-4o can now edit existing images and get this even images with people in them.
Wow, the possibilities there are pretty much endless.
Yeah, think about it. You can transform images or use what they call inpainting, where you add details to both the front and back of a picture.
So like seamlessly adding an object to a photo or changing the background completely.
Exactly that kind of thing.
Incredible. So how did GPT-4o learn to do all this visual magic? What kind of data did they use to train it for images?
OpenAI has shared that GPT-4o was trained using a mix of publicly available data and proprietary data from their partners.
They actually name-dropped Shutterstock as one of those partners, right?
They did.
It's funny how secretive companies are about their training data in this field.
Yeah, the article talks about that too.
That makes sense though, right?
Totally. A lot of AI companies see their training data as like their secret weapon, you know, a competitive advantage.
For sure. Plus there's the whole legal minefield around intellectual property.
Exactly. So it's understandable why they play their cards close to their chest.
Totally. But what about the artists whose work might be in that publicly available data? The article mentioned how OpenAI is trying to respect artists' rights.
That's a huge issue, and it's great that they're addressing it. OpenAI says they've put policies in place to try and stop the AI from directly copying the styles of living artists.
So they're trying to prevent the AI from just ripping off artists' work.
Right, and they've also set up ways for artists to voice their concerns directly.
Like how? What have they done?
Well, they have this opt-out form that artists can use to ask that their work be removed from OpenAI's training data sets.
Oh, that's good to know.
And they've also said that they'll respect requests from website owners who don't want OpenAI's web crawlers taking data, including images from their sites.
Okay, so they're taking concrete steps to deal with this tricky situation.
Yeah, they seem to be trying to get ahead of it, which is good.
Definitely. So zooming out a bit, the TechCrunch article mentioned that this upgrade comes right after Google launched native image output for their Gemini 2.0 Flash.
Yep, Google's jumping into the game too.
Interesting, and they're both using their core models for it, but the public reaction has been pretty different, hasn't it?
You're right. Gemini's image generation went viral on social media, but not all the attention was positive.
What went wrong?
It seems like at first, Gemini 2.0 Flash had very few guardrails in place. So people were doing things like removing watermarks from images and even creating images of copyrighted characters.
Oh, so people are pushing the boundaries.
Yeah, it really shows how important it is to have clear policies and tech safeguards, something that OpenAI seems to be focusing on with this ChatGPT upgrade.
It's a good reminder that with great power comes great responsibility.
Right.
Okay, so let's bring it back to our listeners. What are the key takeaways from this deep dive into ChatGPT's new image powers?
The first big takeaway is that if you're already using ChatGPT to make images or you've been thinking about it, this upgrade with GPT-4o means you're going to get much better images, more detail, and a whole bunch of new editing tools.
And the fact that the model is thinking longer, that's a sign that the output could be more creative too.
Yeah, it suggests that the AI is putting more effort into each image.
Absolutely, and it's not just a separate feature anymore, right?
Nope, it's all integrated. Now, the fact that image generation is baked right into GPT-4o points towards more seamless AI experience. You know, it's not just about text or images separately. The model's getting better at handling both together in a really unified way.
It's like the different parts of the AI are talking to each other now.
That's a great way to think about it.
And the conversation about training data and the rights of artists, that just keeps coming up, doesn't it? It's a big deal in the world of generative AI.
It is, and it's something everyone needs to be aware of. As this technology keeps getting better, we need to understand how companies are approaching these questions. It's crucial for navigating this constantly shifting landscape.
It's like we're all figuring this out together as we go.
Yeah, for sure.
And comparing it to Google's Gemini, it's clear that even though the tech is moving so fast, there are different approaches and challenges when it comes to releasing these powerful image generation features responsibly.
Absolutely. It shows that while the tech itself is amazing, we still need to think carefully about how we use it and what the unintended consequences might be.
It's not just about the can we, it's about the should we.
Exactly.
So to sum it all up, the main takeaway is that ChatGPT's image game has leveled up big time thanks to GPT-4o.
That's it in a nutshell.
You can expect higher quality images, more detail, and a whole new world of editing possibilities.
It's a huge leap forward.
Now we want you to think about this for a second. If your work or creative projects involve visuals in any way, how could these new capabilities change things for you? Could you use this tech to change your process or open up new creative doors?
And looking even further ahead, as AI image generation gets more and more sophisticated and accessible, it raises a big question: what new creative possibilities or unexpected consequences might pop up that we haven't even thought of yet? It's a field that's always evolving, and by staying informed, you can really understand the big picture.
Thanks for joining us today, everyone, and make sure to check back for our next deep dive. Thank you.